I had to understand this because maybe some people have heard this story. Have you heard the story? Okay. And I didn't understand the concept. So you saw something where somebody traded, was it a bobby pin for a house?
It was a paperclip. 2020. I was sitting watching a ton of TV like everybody else, sitting on my couch, and I saw that this guy had done this like 20 years ago, a red paperclip for a house. And honestly, I was like, man, 20 years ago, everyone's done this already. Like 20 more people have probably done this. And I Googled it and nobody else had done it since him. And I was like, I have to be the second person that does this.
Okay, so just in case you don't understand like I didn't, you start with a paperclip and you trade somebody something for something else. And the second thing was earrings, right?
Yeah, so okay. I literally posted to Facebook. Actually, I walked around my own house and thought, what do I have that I can give away? And I just sat in my bathroom, and you have 50 bobby pins laying everywhere. And I'm like, I can get rid of one of these. Like, this sounds fine. I'll take a house for this. So I immediately post to Facebook. And to be honest, everyone thought it was a scam. I was like, I have this dream that this bobby pin will be traded for a house someday. And finally, one woman was like, you know what? I believe in it, and I will trade you a pair of earrings I got for my birthday. So just like that, I traded her. I put it in the mail, and she sent me the earrings, and then it continues on.
I think we have the list of what it goes up to. How many trades did you make to get to the house?
So it was 28 trades total.
And how long?
In the moment, 1 year and 7 months total, which while I was doing it, it felt like an eternity. But then obviously 28 trades, I'm like, I'll take a house in 28 trades, fully paid off, no mortgage, sounds pretty great.
So 28 trades in 1 year and 7 months, you said?
Yeah.
So there were obviously months where nothing was traded, like, because nobody was answering you?
I sent, by my count, 300,000 messages. So meaning I was reaching out to people saying, I have a vacuum cleaner, anybody interested? And honestly, people would say, no, this is a scam. Or at one point, I actually got blocked from Facebook because I had sent so many messages so quickly that they're like, this has to be a robot. This isn't a real person. And I had to be like, please, I am a real person. I'm a little bit crazy, but like a real person.
And so at some point towards the end, you thought you were getting a $20,000 diamond necklace. What did you trade it for that necklace? What did they get?
So at one point, I traded a Mini Cooper convertible to a woman who told me she had a $20,000 necklace. And as I'm saying it out loud now, I'm like, maybe you should have thought about that a little bit. It ended up being a $2,000 diamond necklace when I got to the jewelry shop just to double check on things. I cried in the jewelry shop. I think the guy thought I was crazy as I'm bawling my eyes out. And in that moment, I just said, okay, I need to find who wants this $2,000 diamond necklace. Like, I have this necklace, I've gone back a bunch of steps, but I'm going to keep going. And I had to figure out who was going to be that person, and I found someone.
So when you're trading, like, for instance, she got the Mini Cooper before you got the necklace that was only worth $2,000,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, and then you traded this. Okay, explain the Chipotle card, because there's a celebrity card that I don't have, and I need to know what this is.
All right, Ellen, I'm ready for a trade.
Okay.
I will find you it.
All right, what is the Chipotle celebrity card?
So what it is, there are 3 every single year that get given out to special people. It has no value. So you can walk in and say, I want unlimited burritos for everyone in the store. So it was the first item where I honestly got fixated in trying to find it, because I was like, it has no price. This is the first thing that you can't pay for. So I think a lot of people, when I traded for it, thought, oh, Chipotle reached out to you. This is just a brand. Actually, what they don't know is that I message hundreds of people on LinkedIn who worked at Chipotle being like, hey, it's me, Demi Skipper. I'm here for a trade. I've got a car for you. And they said no, and no, and no. And I finally found one person that worked at Chipotle that said, you know, I'll take a call with you. So I get on the phone, and I'm like, I have this car. Nope, still won't take it. But then I did some research and realized that Chipotle has this foundation where they donate tractors to farmers. So I was like, if I can find someone who wants the car that has tractors, then I'll go back to them with those tractors and say, hey, Chipotle. So exactly that.
Wow.
After 3 or 4 more calls where they continued to say no, I finally was like, I have 3 tractors. And they called back a week later and said, you know what? We'll give you the card.
All right. So we have to take a break. But when we come back, we'll talk about what you traded finally for that house that started with a bobby pin and then what you're going to do next with this house. We'll be back. We're back with Demi Skipper, who traded her she got a bobby pin. And it got her a house in 1 year and 7 months from a bobby pin. Okay, so finally, so you had the tractors. Is that what you traded for the house?
So there's a couple more, that Chipotle celebrity card, and then I got this off-the-grid trailer. So if you can picture it, it's like a food truck almost with solar panels and full electricity, a fridge. I mean, this thing was expensive, and then that's what ended up getting me to the house.
That got you the house.
Yeah.
So now I think we have a picture of the house, and the house is... You want to say where it is? Does it matter where it is?
It's in Clarksville, Tennessee. So it's like 30 minutes outside of Nashville, which honestly, I was willing to go to the middle of nowhere. So this was amazing.
And this was, it's right outside of Nashville. Okay, so the plan is, tell everybody what you want to do with this house.
So as of next week, I'm going to Nashville, fully renovating the house, my husband and I. And then the plan is I'm actually going to trade the house for a bobby pin. So what that means, somebody out there who really, really needs this house is going to get a fully paid off house courtesy of these trades, and then I'm going to get a bobby pin. And then I start all over.
Right. All right. So you need somebody that's going to send you a bobby pin, and you have to figure out who really needs this house.
Yeah.
You're going to send me this bobby pin, okay? And I am going to trade you VIP tickets for two people to come to my farewell season.
Oh,
so that will be your next trade. So you send me the bobby pin, I send you these, and then you'll be able to trade this for something.
Oh, my
All right?
God. Thank you so much. I'm like,
it's a big jump.
I'm usually the one that trades. This is not.
This will be great. This will be a good trade.
I'm shaking.
All right.
This is an amazing trade. My best trade.
I think it's amazing, too. It's fun. All right. I want to thank John Cena and Parquet Courts. I want to thank all of you for watching. Thanks for being a part of my final season. I feel the love in this room. I send it back to you. Take it and go out and spread it around in the world, everybody.